Hi everybody, this is Professor Dellinger and we are in the middle of problem 1-4a. In this second half of that problem, we're going to demonstrate what to do in financial statements, the blank sheet kind, for an example of your graded problem PR-13a. Here you see the accounting grid that we filled out in 1-3A. You have the instructions and the accounting grid. We can cascade those screens so that we could see both. We can also tile the screens. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start with the income statement and we're going to use the data in the accounting grid. So we don't need the instructions anymore. Turn that off, go to the cascading window, and go ahead and open label, accounts and amounts descriptions, open the income statement. Now we're going to tile them with this icon here, and I like to have my labels at the bottom, so I'm going to move them down there, and I think I'm going to put my income statement a little bit smaller so that I can see everything still. And I'll start out with labels. And the first label that we want is the date for the month ended August 31st, 2018. So you highlight that. So you highlight that date. Copy and paste it to the label. Next, you see how it says account here. We're going to be looking for an account balance from our grid. So I'm going to look for the revenue called sales commissions. And I'm going to scroll down to the bottom. I see that the balance is 52.8. So in our labels, we scroll down to the accounts section, we look for sales commissions, copy that, paste it in here, put our balance in of 52.8. Next, we have a label. So scrolling back to labels and accounts, up at the top here, we need the label for expenses. So we'll copy expenses. Paste it in here. And now we just need a list of expenses. So first account of expenses is salaries, so I'll scroll down and I'll find salaries expense. Copy that, paste it, and then scrolling over here looking for my balances, I can see that I have rent expense, auto expense, supplies expense, and miscellaneous. So I can type that in, rent expense, and I can put the balance of rent expense, which is $4,500. Scroll back, I forgot to put the $5,250 in salaries expense. Auto expense. Supplies expense. And be very careful with supplies expense because you do not want the balance of the supplies asset account. So this is on the left side of our equation. Assets are. We want the supplies expense when we're listing expenses. In fact, all of the expenses will say expense. Miscellaneous expense, $1,200. And then it says amount description. So going down to amount description, see the amount descriptions are at the bottom. What we're looking for here is total expenses. And the total of all those expenses are $13,050. And then we have another amount description, which is going to be net income or net loss, and if our revenue accounts are greater than our total expenses, we have revenue, net income, I should say. So I'll copy that, I'll paste it in there, and I'll take the difference between the $52,800 and the $13,050, and that will be $39,750. And I'll go to check my work, and everything looks good. I scored 78 out of 78. I can see up here in the top right hand corner of my income statement. And that's it for this video.